Another one of the last liners was the SS France, which was launched in 1960. Also a national project made more for prestige and possible externalities than direct profitability. The ship was subsidized for its entire career. It was more than 1,000 feet long and was an attempt to re-edit the achievement of the Normandy, but with an offer better suited to the market and the times. There were only two classes. First class, which represented 25% of cabins only, and tourists the rest. The France already announced the transition of liners to cruise ships. What is the difference between the two? Technically, they all are big passenger ships, but an ocean liner is primarily designed to transport passengers from point A to point B. The cruise ship is built for the purpose of taking passengers on a journey. They are pure tourism ships, and even though the journey may include visits outside the ship is the attraction itself. And that means a different design. Cruise ships need to offer a lot of entertainment, from rooms for shows to clubs, casinos, stores. A liner could always be turned into a cruise ship, but its original design could limit it in its capacity. But still, the France became increasingly a ship people sailed on for the cruise itself, not to go to the other side of the Atlantic. And when its losses were amplified by the oil crisis in the 1970s, with the rise in fuel costs, it was sold to a Norwegian cruise company and changed name. It became the Norway. That was a little national tragedy in France at the time, because it symbolized how the times for this kind of national prestige projects were over. As the Norway, she was operated with success as a cruise ship until the 1980s. And since the 1980s, cruise ships have completely overtaken, replaced liners.